I can't do it. I just can't walk into that court and look right and sound right and cry at all the right moments. I can't do it.
No one's asking you to. All anyone's suggesting is that you stop hiding. Just simply tell the court what happened to you in the way you told Wilkins.
What difference will it make?
All the difference in the world. How can anyone possibly understand what you've been through unless you tell them?
Well, if you want them back, take them. But I thought they were for Kat. I thought she was your friend.
She is. She's my real good friend.
Well, if you don't care about her headaches.
I do. They're gonna fix her up, aren't they? You sure?
Oh, they'll fix her up, Mel. They're gonna fix her right up.
Where the hell did you get that from?
Mr. Big Shot!
You bent him. Geez. 5 minutes after he's been in the door.
Well, he didn't have much choice.
Yeah, you know that tape that got roasted in the oven? He was all over it, handing over $100 to Roach.
For what?
For that pillow full of grass. Most expensive bunch of MCs ever bought.
Top dog first.
You stupid buggers. Could have had a regular supply.
Here you go, Liz.
Roach!
What are we creeping around for?
Oh, use your luck. Take a look at this one. It'd be great if the screw saw her, wouldn't it?
Oh, but they saw her in the shower block.
Standing still.
Yeah, well, they better smarten up their act. They're dead if they turn up in court looking for her. Yeah, where's Auntie Ida?
Come on.
Now, look. I'm sick of running around after you. You can't go to sleep in the corridors. You might catch cold or something. Yeah, well, you shouldn't have got drunk then, should you? Come on, you're too old to go drinking at your age.
Too old to be bothered. I've had more shivers in my life than you ever had breakfast on.
Stop shouting, will you?
Shh. Now, listen, get out of your cell and start pouring coffee into her.
Hey, stop talking about me, you long bloody idiot.
If she gives you any trouble,
oh,
you
just... come off, and why me?
Because you two have got a front up in court today, and I'm on kitchen duty, and if she blows it, you'll both be back here before you know what's hit you.
Okay, okay, okay. God, why is everybody shouting? Now, come on, you, get in.
Don't you start shoving me off.
I know. You'll deck me. Get in.
I'll get you.
They are going to plead guilty, aren't they?
Yeah, that's what they said. Why?
Well, the judge wouldn't believe them if they said anything else. They look worse than I feared.
Yeah, well, serves you right for having my share of the booze.
Oh, don't start that again.
Yeah, well, it was my scam.
And it is our baby, and we don't want anything to happen to our little darling.
What's this our baby, Capra? It didn't stop you from sucking the sauce bottle, did it?
Don't remind me. I've got to work in the kitchen with that food.
Oh, don't say nothing. Don't get in my way, because I don't think I can stop. Don't mention food. Don't mention booze. Don't ask me how I am. Am I going the right way? Don't tell them. I don't care.
What a bunch of wowsers. Come on. Mervyn will be screaming for it.
Ryder, you get back to yourself!
You had a rotten night, didn't you?
I'm sorry, love. Did I keep you up?
No, you didn't. I was awake most of the night, too. I hate it when I can't sleep.
Yes, it's lonely, isn't it?
You're worried about going to court, aren't you?
Yeah.
I thought so. That's why I didn't say nothing.
Thanks, Mel. That was very thoughtful of you.
It's rotten when people don't let you think. I was thinking last night, too, but I got sad, so I stopped.
Oh, what made you sad?
Nothing, just thoughts.
Well, you wouldn't like to share them with me.
Oh, I was thinking about you going to court, too, and how lonely it'd be without you. And I want you to get off and... Shut up! Shut up! Stop laughing! Stop it!
No, they're not laughing at you.
I didn't mean to yell.
It doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter. We've gone now. And what were you saying?
I just wish I was going with you. I'm different on the outside. I know I am. I can remember.
Mel, did you take your medication yesterday?
I took them off Sister Hall. I did, Kath. I took them off Sister Hall.
Right. You just seem a bit tense, that's all.
Kath, I reckon I'd do anything to get out of here, wouldn't you? I'd even give up me comics, wouldn't you, Kath?
Yes. Yes, I would.
Oh, Mervyn, will you please get dressed?
I'm trying to, but I can't find the trousers I pressed last night. I left them hanging over the chair.
I put them away. They were making the place look untidy.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Joyce, this is ridiculous. She won't be looking in our bedroom.
Of course she will.
Not me running around looking like this, she won't. And my wallet, where's that?
Bedside table top drawer.
Oh, I give up. Anyone thinks she's bringing one of those photographers from a house magazine with
her? Get dressed.
All right, come on.
Morning. Come in.
I've just been having a look round outside. It seems very nice.
Oh, yes. Did you see where the rubbish bins go?
In that little shed out the back.
Yes, that's right. I'll leave you to have a look around. I have to get Mervyn's breakfast.
He's running late, isn't he?
Oh, yes, my fault, I'm afraid. You see, I ran the vac over last night and, well, I forgot to plug the alarm clock back in when I'd finished. Not very popular this morning.
The joys of married life, eh? Well, I'll keep out of your way. Through there?
Yes, and don't mind the packing cases. They're going with us.
You're right, Josie. I should have known it. She came into the bedroom. 2 days, Josie. Even if the solicitors haven't signed for our new place, 2 days and we're out.
Bloody marvellous. And we're only here to help Mervyn. He doesn't even bother turning up.
Oh, stop complaining. We wouldn't be having these cankleberries if he wanted, would we?
As long as nothing's happened to him.
Oh, not with Joycey looking after him. Hey, don't forget to turn mine over. I hate all that gooey stuff.
Oh, do the eggs. You stick to the toast.
Cut the yolks out of Lexi's. What the hell for?
Cholesterol, little mother, and I want you to finish that orange juice sweat.
No bloody way. I have had 3 glasses and I'm not having any more.
Suit yourself. Look, does anyone know where Mervyn keeps his headache powders?
Wouldn't be in here, love.
No way.
Somebody told him there was a thief in the block.
I have to do something, Friday Ida. No? Orange juice. Be back in a minute.
Does anyone want to hear the good news?
Not if you're going to say it like that.
Oh, I can't help it. I'm sick. Oh, do you want to hear it or don't you?
Yeah.
Well, I've just seen a list of names for work experience.
Yes? Oh.
Me, Nancy, Laurie, and Reed.
Yeah! What about me?
No, you dipped out. Oh, it's a horrible thing to do.
What's so bloody funny? I was terrific yesterday. I should have been on that list too.
I can't understand what happened. Just the 4 of us. And the 3. What do you reckon, Nance?
Oh, Kath, I'm so pleased you're taking a solicitor's advice.
Funny, isn't it? I hate liars, and yet that's what I'll be doing.
If everyone's going to lie to you, you have to fight back, don't you? By condemning you, what they're really doing is saying that they wouldn't do the same thing. How would they know? How would anyone know what they do in a case like that unless they were faced with it?
Thanks, but I don't think that'll carry too much weight in court.
Three's a crowd, Wilkinson. Get lost.
Anyway. Good luck. I hope we don't see each other again, if you know what I mean.
Thanks.
Well, I better get this orange juice to Auntie Ida. And how long have you been there?
Very fun.
Oh, just as long as I can see a smile on your face.
Your thick mate tells me you think you'll be winning your case today.
Stranger things have happened.
Not in this joint, they don't. You got Buckley's, Maxwell.
I don't believe it. Rampant jealousy.
You are one of a kind, Williams. Even in a cesspool like this, you're one of a kind.
Shut it.
Even if you do fluke it, I won't be complaining. Because I'll have your dummy mate to play
with. You'll leave her alone.
Yeah? No way. I've been watching the way you make her perform. It's easy.
She does not perform. I'm her friend.
Yeah. Well, now I'm going to be her friend, aren't I? And there's not a bloody thing you can do about it.
Good luck in court.
Dead set cert to get on that list. It's not bloody fair.
Don't swear in front of the governor.
Well, it's not, Mrs. Pringle. I mean, I'll leave those others for dead.
Lexi.
Look, you should know, Mrs. Reynolds. What about when your daughter gave those screen printing classes? That was terrific.
No one's denying that, but you weren't 6 months pregnant then.
What's that got to do with anything?
Lexi, I am responsible for every woman in this prison. If I let you go on that work program and something happened to your baby...
Nothing will happen.
Legal complications and red tape would be enormous, not to mention my own personal feelings.
All right, put it this way. I mean, what can happen out there that can't happen in here? God, it is a prison. I mean, the place is full of crooks.
Good point. That's why I'm moving you to maternity as soon as there's room.
Maternity? Me? Why?
Because you're pregnant and that's where you'll get the best care.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Reynolds, the place is full of ankle biters.
But mostly for your own protection. I'm sorry, Lexi, I've let you stay in HBOC too long. You'll be transferred as soon as there's a vacancy and I believe that'll be in 2 days' time.
My mates.
I can't see why you're not worried. She's going to kill Ferguson.
When we go out from work experience, yes, I know.
What are you so happy about?
It's not that I'm happy, I'm just not that worried, that's all.
Oh. Stop frowning. The wind will change. Now, why would they send the deputy governor out the gardens when there's so many other guards to do it?
What do you mean?
They must think we're pretty nice people, otherwise they wouldn't have chosen us. I'm betting they're going to send some nice young trainees.
Oh, I do hope you're right.
What do you want, Maxwell? I thought we'd got rid of you.
Not yet. Can we talk?
It's a free prison.
Really? How things have changed.
Not for kid killers. That'll never change.
Look, I don't want to waste time going through all that again. I'm here to ask a favour.
Yeah? This'll be good.
Come on, at least listen to her.
Some people seem to think that I won't be coming back here after today.
Oh, that'd be right. Your sort always gets off.
I doubt it, but if that does happen, I'm worried about Mool. I'm worried that she might suffer because of what I've done. Because of what I've made her do in the past.
No, we wouldn't do that.
I know you wouldn't, or Laurie, but please, she's just a lovely, decent child. Give her kindness and she'll give it back. All she craves for is friendship. Don't be cruel to her. Please.
Maxwell. She'll be all right.
I feel like a bloody old wood duck after a bushfire. Why we got to put on all these airs and graces, love? Why can't we go as we are?
Because we're different. And they don't like things to be different, so will you shut up and let me finish my eyes?
You said you was going to help me, lovey. Auntie Ida's very sick.
OK, in a minute. What have you come as? The horrible hooker?
Don't you start shouting at me and blame bloody Nancy. She got the bloody frock.
I'm not talking about the frock. I'm talking about your face. You look like you've caught something.
You don't know what you're talking about. All the kids put their slap on like that.
Hey, Lex.
My face looks all right to you, don't it, love?
No, it's bloody awful. What do you want?
Well, I think I know the answer. Girl said you were going to front rent her about work experience. No go, eh?
Of course it's no bloody go. Now she's going to send me up to maternity.
Patterson, aren't you in the laundry?
No, I'm in here talking to these two.
Beg your pardon?
Yeah, I'm in the laundry.
You two be at the security gate in 5 minutes, right?
At least my face the bloody side better than her old diet. Hey, what you doing?
Get here.
No, love, no.
She's unreal, isn't it? I mean, how do you figure someone like her out?
Who knows? Not me, that's for sure.
Well, I don't know. I reckon it'd take someone special to worry about somebody like Looney. She really was worried.
How'd you go?
Oh, yeah. I'm so lucky the bitch is sending me to maternity. Transferred.
Yeah, the bitch.
Oh, Lexi, look, don't be like that. It is the best for you and the baby.
Oh, forget it! I just don't want to know. I just don't want to bloody know.
I made a very stupid mistake yesterday. I forgot. I let my guard down. And you lot thought all your Christmases had come at once. Right, Connors? You and your little bunch thought you had me.
Not them. Me. And there was no thought to it, Ferguson. You were dead.
Rita, you're only making it worse.
Shut up, Wilkinson.
Well, Rita's right. If we hadn't saved you...
Oh, yes, I forgot. The cavalry. Wonderful people who risked all to save me. Why? Because you loved me? No wonder. Do you love me, Jenkins? You had your chance, and now it's my turn.
She's gone.
What?
Kath, she's gone. Gina saw the wagon through her cell window. Rotten, isn't it?
I mean, I reckon she's about the best mate I ever had.
She was my mate, mine. We were the best mates in the whole prison.
Oh, yeah. I mean, she liked you better than she liked me. I didn't mean that.
She stopped people calling me names.
Yeah, and look what you did for her. Gave her your capsules and everything. I mean, hell, I wish I had a mate like that.
Yeah, me capsules. I gotta take them today.
Oh, I don't know, Merle. Might be real dangerous.
Yeah, but I'm starting to feel how I used to feel.
But don't you remember what Kat said? She said once you stop taking them, it's real dangerous to start again. She was real worried about you.
Was she?
Yeah. And she made me promise to be your mate and stop Connors and her friends from calling you that name.
They better not, Earl. They just better not, that's all.
Nah, of course they won't. Not when they see that I'm your friend. How about it, Will? We gonna be mates just like Kath wanted?
Yeah, mates. Just like Kath.
You were carrying on about in the slammer, eh?
Oh, well, you gotta go for a bit of sympathy, love. You wait till I get to the court, I'll turn it on for you then.
Well, you'd better start. Because we're here.
No, no, we get off next stop. This is a Supreme Court here.
Like walking into a morgue or something.
We've just been talking about Roach and Ida. They really wouldn't send Ida back, would they, Top Dog?
No way. They'd just slap her wrist and tell her to act her age.
Oh, well, that's the trouble, as far as I can tell. No one knows how old she really is.
Well, let's just say she's been 64 for the past 18 years.
Oh, 82!
Oh, oh, God. Hey, well, how's tricks? What you reading?
Comic. And no jokes about only looking at the pictures, OK?
What's wrong with the pictures? I reckon they're terrific. Hey, who's the redneck?
Jelly man, he melts through keyholes and he turns red when he's angry and
bloody hell! Who buggered the table?
What's wrong with it?
The pocket's all ripped. Come on, who's the dummy who did it?
The ball wouldn't go down and don't call me names, all right? Just don't do it!
Should have bloody
known. All right, behave yourselves. In fact, why don't you give Merle a game, Lex?
Forget it.
Come on, I will, Merle.
You've got a big complex, you know that?
What did I do?
Now,
she's
listen,
the one...
Brett. You've been sulking ever since Reno said no to the work experience. Now, it's not our fault, so cut it out.
Oh, come on, Lex, I'll give you a game. Geez, I'm sick of everyone blueing around this place.
She's carrying on because she can't go. And you two are twitchy because I can go. It's funny, isn't it?
No, I don't think so. But then I don't think murder's very funny at all.
Killing the freaks and not murder.
Oh, no.
What's wrong?
I've copped Rodney for every afternoon shift next week.
Somebody up there's paying you back for something.
I just thought they already had. How many places did we go to this morning? 9?
10.
Oh, what's the matter with these people? Guaranteed cheap labour, officers to guard them. What else do they want?
Sounds like somebody had a bad morning.
You could say that.
You wouldn't believe some of the excuses we got.
Oh, yes, I would. I warned you.
Yes, I know, Mrs. Reynolds, but... there was no sense to what they had to say. As soon as they heard the word prisoners, that was it. No discussion, finish, end of conversation.
And Marty was wonderful too. Made the deal sound really attractive.
Well, you've still got plenty of time. Unless you think it's hopeless, of course.
Oh, no, we're not giving up.
Well, no, we'll be at it again tomorrow.
Good. Well, there's more to life than work experience. Aren't you two supposed to be on duty? I know what they're going through. I had the same trouble when I was in family welfare.
Well, I'm not worried. With Bulldog Jackson on the job, they'll get something. I mean, they may end up in the Army or the Navy, but they'll get something.
Well, that reminds me, Bob Moran called.
Oh, how is he?
Fine. In fact, we might see him today. He's coming down to be a character witness for Kath Maxwell.
Poor Bob. Do you think if she gets off, they'll get together?
It's a very big if. First of all, she has to convince the court that she's sorry for killing her little girl. And she isn't Meg. She killed that child because she loved her.
Would you mind waiting outside while I talk to Mrs. Maxwell?
Oh, no, no, of course not.
Thank you. You were wonderful, Mrs. Maxwell. I watched you walk through that crowd and you were perfect.
It was a lie.
It's what they wanted to see.
So that's what it's come down to, has it? It makes them feel good if I shed the occasional tear. Well, I don't think I can keep it up.
You'll have to.
When I saw those sanctimonious faces, I wanted to scream. I wanted them to know why I killed Linda.
They know why, Now they want you to be sorry for it.
I'm not. The child was suffering.
And unless they see you suffering, unless the crowd, the press and the court see you suffering, you'll spend the rest of your life in Wentworth. The plea has been changed to manslaughter. Now, that took a lot of hard work and bargaining, so please, please, don't let yourself down now.
What about my character witnesses?
Bob Moran will be here on time.
And my husband?
Mrs. Maxwell, everything is all right. Trust me, I know my job.
Perhaps we could get her to attack someone.
Who?
Oh, I don't know, someone she isn't very fond of.
Well, it'd hardly be someone she likes. Mm. I don't like it anyway.
Why not?
I don't like people hitting each other. Besides, Top Dog would end up in solitary.
Oh, well, that's the whole point. But not solitary necessarily, but Lisa would get her off the work experience program.
No.
We could help her to escape. How would that help?
She could hardly kill Joan Ferguson while the police were out hunting for her.
Oh, they might shoot her or
but
something.
But how would they? They wouldn't know anything about it. I mean, oh. If they... Oh, how would they know? Forget it.
You know this... You know this judo thing you do?
Hmm, what about it?
Well, couldn't you break something so she'd have to stay here?
Break something?
Oh, just her little finger or something? No, that's horrible. I'm sorry. Forget I said that.
Yes, I will.
Catherine Maxwell, you have been charged with the manslaughter of your daughter, Linda Jane Maxwell. How do you plead?
Guilty. But I want the court to know that... the circumstances of...
The accused will have every opportunity to speak later.
No! I loved her! I loved my daughter!
And so, Your Honour, only a person who has cared for the sick can begin to understand. And even then, they can have no conception of the agony that Catherine Maxwell suffered during those four long, loving years. Years selflessly sacrificed for her little daughter. There was no respite. Medical science openly admitted they could do no more for her. There was no rest. Even in her sleep, she could hear the cries that haunted her every waking moment. Now, Your Honour, we're not saying that she didn't put an end to her child's life. What we're saying is that her actions were not premeditated. We're saying that this woman was driven beyond the bounds of human endurance and put an end to her child's suffering in a moment of total despair.
Murderer! She's a murderer!
Order! Order! I will clear the courtroom if there are any similar outbursts. This is a court of law.
Your Honour, I would ask this man be sent from the court.
I have given my ruling, Mr. Bladen.
But Your Honour...
Go on, Mr. Bladen.
Yes, Your Honour.
You are charged with entering the premises of J&R McKenzie Milk Bar and unlawfully demanding money whilst in possession of a firearm. How do you plead?
Not guilty.
Shut up, will you?
Oh, that's right. Excuse me. Would you mind changing that to guilty? And I'll share you a drink.
He's talking to me, you bloody idiot.
Well, how was I to know he said something?
Madam!
Yes, Your Worship?
Your Honour.
Beg yours.
You address me as... Oh, it doesn't matter. Is the accused hard of hearing?
Hey, hang on there. If you're talking about me, I'll tell you, I can hear a tinny fizz 100 yards away.
A tinny fizz?
Yeah.
What's the woman talking about?
I think she's saying that her hearing isn't impaired, Your Honour.
Her hearing? What's that got to do with the case?
You asked me if she was hard of hearing.
Excuse me, Your Worship.
Your Honour.
Oh, thanks, but just call me Ida. Is there any chance of a cuppa? My mouth feels like the bottom of a cocky's cage.
Madam, I wonder if we could confine discussion to the case at hand. You may have a tinny fizz or a cuppa during the adjournment. God knows we shall all need something by then.
How good are you? Don't eat chalk. Nice.
What in me? What in blooming thing?
Lisa, move.
Go away.
Oh, come on, mate. I tell you what, I'll help you clean up. Do you want a lawyer?
Why?
I just thought you might like one, that's all.
Why do you want me to help me?
because we're mates. And mates always...
That's me, mate. She's the only friend I ever had.
Yeah, but she's gone. Now I'm your mate, remember? Well, before she left,
Cass... Yeah, I know all of that. But how do I know you're not lying? You're not going to try and get me to bash someone or something.
Bash someone? Why would I do that? I mean, Connors is the only one that said anything rotten about you. And I told her to shut up, so who would I want bashed?
Rena was nice to me. She's...
Yeah, that's while you were there. But when you left, she started making jokes about you and Jellyman.
She liked him. I heard her say it.
Oh, yeah. Geez, it's rotten when people talk about you behind your back, isn't it? I tell you what, I'll leave some lollies in your dorm, okay?
She liked him. She thought he was terrific.
Oh! Oh, thank heavens. I've been looking everywhere for you.
Nancy, what is the matter? Something terrible's happened, hasn't it?
Oh, no, not at all. I've worked out how to stop her.
Nancy, you just scared me half to death.
Now, are you doing a kitchen pickup?
You're talking about Rita, right?
Yes, are you doing a kitchen pickup?
You don't have to yell at me!
What? Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, you're right. Relax, relax, relax.
Now this. Whatever it is you're talking about, we'll stop Rita doing the work program, right?
No doubt at all about it. In fact, with a bit of luck, she might end up in solitary.
Nancy.
Well, there's no guarantee Miss Ferguson won't be sent out there as well, and it's too big a risk.
Well, so she ends up in solitary. What's the kitchen got to do with it?
In a nutshell, we steal some food or something, and we hide it in Rita's cell.
And?
Well, don't you see, she was working in the kitchen this morning. They'll think she stole whatever it is we hide in her cell.
Oh, but that'll mean one of us have to lag.
Oh, no, it doesn't. Oh, well, just leave all that to me. What do you think? At least I won't have to break a little finger.
Now, Mrs. Maxwell, in your own words, just as you told me.
Linda, my daughter, suffered more in 4 years than any of us will suffer in a lifetime. Two lifetimes. I know because I suffered every minute with her. She was a good child. She would try so hard to smile if I gave her something. Once I gave her a small giraffe as a present, and for some reason she thought it was very funny. Unfortunately, the effort of laughing set off an attack that lasted 14 hours. She never laughed again. Laughing hurt. I know what the papers have said about me, and I suppose I can't really blame them, but they're wrong when they say that I didn't love her. I always loved her, and I still do. I used to pray for some miracle to stop her pain. But God wasn't interested. Or wasn't there.
Atheist! Murdering atheist!
Remove that man from the court!
Mrs. Maxwell, do you think you could tell us about Linda's death?
No. I have tried to remember, but I can't. I can remember her screaming with pain. And then the screaming had stopped. And I was holding a pillow.
Do you intend going on, Mr. Bladen?
No, Your Honor.
Step down, Mrs. Maxwell. Do you intend introducing your two character witnesses now, Mr. Bladen?
No, Your Honor. I would appreciate a short adjournment before that happens.
I'm sure you would. I do wish you gentlemen would prepare your witnesses prior to the hearing. You have 1 hour.
Yes, I've got that. Anyone hurt? I'll keep my fingers crossed for you. Thanks for calling. Let me know what happens. Yes, bye. Brody, Kennedy, Deacon, no visitors until further notice.
Trouble?
Could be. That was Bob Moran. They're in the middle of a riot at the prison farm. He thinks there could be a spill over to here.
What's that got to do with us?
Their husbands are out there. In fact, Brody's husband's a ringleader.
Right. Well, I hate to sound uncharitable, and I'm sorry for Bob. But I'm glad it's not us for a change.
Yes, but it's bad news for Maxwell. I think she's going to need all the character witnesses she can get.
You were excellent. If every client followed instructions as you have, I'd be a very happy man.
What went wrong?
Nothing, I told you.
Shall we save the lies for the courtroom, Mr. Bladen?
I saw your face when character witnesses were mentioned. Now, what's wrong?
Bob Moran won't be here. There's been a riot at his prison and he has to sue.
Right, he's not hurt, is he?
No, no, nothing like that, but I'm afraid we've lost him as a witness.
What about the other witness? I haven't seen my loving husband in court.
Mrs. Maxwell, what you did out there was worth 20 characters.
Where's Alan?
He said he couldn't afford to be involved. I'm sorry, he's not coming.
Don't look so surprised, Mr. Bladen. I'm not.
Good. Because you've gained ground. Don't lose it. That's why I called the adjournment. I want you to relax, be positive, forget about your husband and win.
I'll force myself. Now, if there's nothing else.
Of course. We've done it. Believe me, you'll be on a bond and free as a bird before the day is out.
Maxwell, Mr. Bladen told me about your husband and, well, I think it's disgusting and I'm very sorry. You think he's a monster, don't you? He isn't. He's really a very nice man. The only trouble is he buries his head in the sand. If he doesn't like something, he doesn't look at it. But you're his wife. And Linda was his daughter. He loved her, but he couldn't bear to see her suffering, so he just worked longer hours. It's a clever defense, really. He sort of rationed Linda's pain to 1 hour a day. If that's all he saw, that's all she suffered. He's doing the same thing with me. If he doesn't see me in prison, it doesn't hurt him. Which means it doesn't hurt me. It's really a very good system.
I've never heard of anything so ridiculous in all my life. Some of the greatest chefs in the world use brown sugar.
Then they're wrong. I'm sorry, but my mother made the best souffle in the country.
Jacques Brunner is wrong?
Never heard of him. Who is he? Some short order cook, I suppose.
I don't believe this. This is not really happening.
Laurie, now, you're no slouch in the kitchen. Soufflés, brown or white sugar?
Oh, heavens, don't ask me. I mean, it depends on whether or not you want a brown or a white soufflé.
That has nothing to do with it.
Oh, that's right. They're mainly made with eggs, aren't
you're
they?
You're not going to
say... Brown sugar with brown souffle.
She said it.
And white sugar with white souffle.
I don't want to talk about this anymore.
Oh, well, if you're going to get out of it like that.
Listen, why don't you stop arguing? Why don't you look it up in that lovely big recipe book of yours, Mervyn?
Will you accept that?
Well, of course. Good heavens. Anyone would think I was being unreasonable.
Soufflés. Strawberry soufflé with liqueur. 1 pint of fresh strawberries and 1/4 cup of kirsch.
Oh, yes, but that's a hot soufflé. Course you use brown sugar. Everyone knows that.
Yeah, but that's what I said.
Did you? Good heavens. Must be talking about two entirely different things. By the way, Mervyn, why are we talking about soufflés?
Did you get your jelly beans?
Ah, good. Just had some bad news, Mill. I just met Reno at the gates, and she said Kath's got her bond. She's out, Mill. We've lost our friend.
Mervyn, is all this really necessary?
What do you mean? Of course it is.
All the time we're wasting. And why chocolate pudding? Why not treacle pudding?
It's not just that. I have to account for a stock list. Now, keep looking.
Look, I think we had it yesterday.
Yesterday?
Oh, no, of course not. No, we had bread and butter pudding yesterday. Rita wasn't very happy about that, was she?
She's not the only person in here.
Now, don't go telling her we nearly had chocolate pudding, will you? I've never known anybody as mad about chocolate as she is. I think she'd sell her own mother for a piece of... What's wrong?
Rita, she was working in here this morning.
Ah, well, that settles it then. If she couldn't find it, it can't be here.
It wasn't lost this morning, it was here on the bench. Rita, of course.
Oh, dear. Sorry, Rita.
Before you and Kath came along, I had no one to talk to. Geez, it was lonely. You know what I mean, don't you? I suppose that's why Kath wants us to be friends.
What's wrong with her? What are you up to?
Get lost, Wilkinson. I'm talking to me mate.
You're what?
You heard.
I think she can do without friends like you. The warriors are looking after her now.
Kath's gone. She's not coming back.
It's just a possibility, Merle.
It's true. Reno told Janet so. It's true.
Keep your mouth shut, all right? Why don't you leave? What are you going to tell her?
Nothing. She's confused enough, thanks to you. Now, why don't you leave before I call Rita?
It's going to be all right, Merle. I'll be back in a minute, okay? I just have to do something, and I'll be back with you.
Yeah, I'd like that. Because I'm lonely, and I never felt like this before.
Oh, Merle.
Oh, no. Where's Mr. Pringle, Nancy?
Oh, look, I'm not too sure. He just said something about chocolate, and he rushed out of the kitchen. Is there anything I can do?
We'd really appreciate a sandwich or something. Mm. We missed out on lunch.
Cheese and tomato, okay?
Oh, yes, please. Not too much cheese on mine, thanks. Come on, mate, forget it. It's not the end of the world.
Maybe not, but it's the end of the work experience, isn't it?
No. Well, I don't know. At least we gave it our best shot.
Yep, right between the eyes and killed it stone dead.
Excuse me, but does this mean we won't be going outside?
It's starting to look that way. We tried everything,
but the chocolate... Oh, look, I am sorry. I have to go.
Are you all right?
No, not really. Mr. Pringle... No. Look, I am sorry.
Can't even crack it for a sandwich. I give up.
Now, this is dreadful.
Don't worry. If it's here, we'll find it.
I don't mean that. I'm just sorry I made such a fuss. I mean, it's only a bit of chocolate, isn't it?
It's not the point. Next time, it could be a knife.
Oh, I just got mad. They know that you only have to ask. I know I'm not supposed to, but what's a bit of chocolate?
Well, I thought you said it was a kilo block.
Petey!
I'm talking about when they're
I'm
in
sorry,
the
but I haven't done
this. Get off
of that. I'll explain later.
Putting it over on me, but it doesn't matter.
Well, I'm not saying she didn't take it, but it's certainly not here. Let's try the laundry.
No, I don't want to embarrass her if she didn't do it.
But you said that you...
I know, but I think I'll just have one more look through the kitchen, just in case, eh?
Shut up! He wants to talk to you.
Miss Brown?
Yes, she was.
It's been a fascinating day in more ways than one. But all good things must come to an end, so would you mind standing, please?
I don't mind standing up, your worship.
Thank you. Ida Brown, while I cannot condone your involvement in the crime, I must take into consideration your advanced years and the period already spent on remand. Therefore, I am placing you on a 2-year bond. Do you understand?
Does that mean I don't have to go back to the slammer?
It does. Step down, please.
You little beauty! Oh, thanks, Your Majesty. Oh, see you all later, everyone. Catch you later, Roger, baby.
Rachel Waters, the growing incidence of armed robbery in the country is alarming, and this court will do everything in its power to deter future participants. Rachel Waters, the court sentences you to...
Oh, hang on. Look, the gun was only plastic. It wasn't real.
The court sentences you to a period of 6 months' imprisonment without remission or parole.
Counsel for the accused has been very eloquent in his description of the long-suffering mother. Unfortunately, very little has been said about the rights of the child. Even less has been said about the accused's moral obligation to the law of the land. This obligation will not be seen to be taken lightly in this courtroom. Catherine Maxwell, I sentence you to the maximum penalty by law, life imprisonment.
Sorry, that shouldn't have happened.
Why? I lied out there. I did what they wanted. Why?
I'm not sure. But my assistant was just told that the judge's wife has been terminally ill for the last 2 years.
Oh, so he's putting me in jail for doing what he hasn't got the guts to do himself, is that it?
Appeal to the High Court as soon as I can.
Everyone told me I wouldn't have to go back there, and I believed them. Idiot! I believed them!
we left this for a while, Mr. Bladen. I don't think she's in a fit state now.
Yes, Mr. Bladen, leave it, Mr. Bladen. Let her get settled into a new home first. You can't miss it. There's barbed wire all the way around it. And there's no great hurry. Thanks to you, I'll be there for the rest of my life.
Oh, Mr. Pringle, thank heavens you're here. Now, I started on the pudding. I wasn't sure how much chocolate you wanted to use.
Chocolate?
Well, I saved some for the sauce. Oh, yes, of course, I forgot. I found it in the cool room after you left. You must have forgotten.
But I looked in the cool room.
Really? Well, that's where it was.
Then why did you tell me that Rita had stolen it?
Mr. Pringle, I did not. Now, that's a dreadful thing to say. You said something about old Rita having been working in the kitchen, and then you rushed out, and I wonder what was wrong.
Is that right?
Well, I don't know. I suppose so. One of those mornings. Brown sugar.
Nancy, what is going on?
Pudding, Mrs. Morris. Great big chocolate pudding.
Rotten little bitch.
She didn't say any more than that.
Afraid not. I just got so angry I just kicked her out.
She said, want to be careful. Looney might have donged you one.
Oi!
What?
The name.
Oh, yeah, I'll keep forgetting.
All right, well, what are we going to do?
Well, it seems pretty straightforward to me. Unless you and Nancy want to start protecting Janet too.
Don't be silly. Not over this one. What's going on?
Never mind. Okay, after work in the rec room, the slime gets taught a lesson.
Hey, can we all have a go at her?
Why not? It's about time we all had a bit of fun.
Oh, you're not kidding.
Oh, hell, I forgot about you. You better keep out of it.
Oh, come on, Red. I'm not going to be with you for long.
No!
Bastards. It was a plastic gun. 6 months for a plastic gun. Well, they can stick it. Because there's no way that I'm going back there. I'm getting out as soon as I... Oh, watch what you're doing, you stupid bastards! Well, say something, will you? I'm talking to you, you stupid bitch. Look, I told you what happened to me. What did you cop?
G'day, Slimy. What you watching?
It's stuff.
Where's Merle?
Ask the Warriors. You reckon they're looking after her now?
Good, I'm hungry. Anyone know what's for tea?
Williams.
Yeah? What's it gonna be, Slime?
Ah, I mean, she's it.
You bitch, Wilkinson. You told them.
Geez, you're quick, Slimy. I thought you were never gonna turn around.
What do you want?
Little Dickie Bird told us you've been telling fibs.
Yeah, well, she's a bloody liar.
Oi, that's my mate you're talking about, Lexi Kidney.
Oh, yeah, well, she didn't understand what I was doing. I mean, Kat's not coming back, is she? So I was just getting Looney ready
Merle.
For
Merle.
Yeah, I was just getting Merle ready for it.
Oh, you were doing a good turn. And here's us thinking nasty things about you.
What are you going to do?
What do you think? We're going to give you a good kicking.
Yeah, a real good kicking, just to remind you.
Hang on, I can hear someone.
Split up.
Lexi, don't. What's all the excitement? Oh. What's so bloody funny? She got away.
Big deal.
Let her sweat.
We'll get her next time.
Bitches. Sorry, mate, you might have helped me out. I just had a go at Connors and her mates, and I think they're after me. Well, come on, I did it for you.
Did what?
Stuck up for you and Kath. You know that name they started calling you? Well, they're doing it again. Only this time they made up a song about it, and they're laughing like crazy. Yeah, and that was bad enough. But then they started getting stuck into Kath, and that's when I really got mad. Yeah, they reckon Kath's a kid killer, and she didn't really like you at all.
She does, she's my friend.
Yeah, I know all that. But they reckon she's only using you. Well, come on, will you?
They said that? They said that about Kath?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. around.